Well, folks, this is Guruji online, and I am Sanjay Singh speaking from this platform. Today, we are going to solve some JEE Advanced problems. This problem I have listed on the board has come in 2013. This problem is like this. We have a copper wire with different diameters. This portion whose length is 2L has got radius as 2R, and this portion whose length is L has got radius as R. Now this wire is stretched with force F, and we have to find out the ratio of elongation in the thin wire to the thick wire. And we have these options given. So this is a real-time JEE Advanced problem. Let us see the solution. We know that stress is proportional to strain. Due to this force, there will be stress developed in this wire. Now, this sigma is proportional to strain, that is, sigma is equivalent to Young's modulus into strain. This is the property of the material. So for both of these, this property will be the same. So Young's modulus is nothing but equal to sigma upon strain. That is, if we equate from here, sigma A upon this strain A is equal to sigma B upon strain B, that is equal to stress is nothing but force upon area. Now in this, stress will be F upon area of this, and in this portion this will be F upon area of this wire, and here the F will remain the same, because if we draw the free body diagram, then it will be like this only. So here the force acting between those two portions will be the same, and upon strain is nothing but elongation upon the length. This is the elongation upon 2L, and this is in this portion elongation upon L, this is the length. So we can find out the ratio like this, since this area will be having 4 times because it is 2R, that is, area is pi R square, so it will be 4 times. So this ratio will be 4 times, and this ratio is 1/2, and the answer will come as 2, means the elongation in the thin wire to the thick wire will be 2. So our answer is basically C. So I hope this is clear. So we will go to the next problem. So this is the second question we are going to solve. This question has also come in JEE Advanced 2013. This question is like this. A ray of light traveling in the direction 1/2 I + √3j is incident on a plane mirror. This is the plane mirror. After reflection, then it is reflected in the direction 1 by 2 I minus root 3 J. So we have to find out the angle of incidence. That is this angle. So we are given this incident ray and the ray of reflection in the form of vectors. So as we know from our dot product, this A dot B is nothing but AB cos alpha. So from this we can find out what is the angle alpha here. Here cos alpha is nothing but here A, that is 1 by 2 I plus root 3 J dot one by two I minus root three J divided by, this is the magnitude of this, 1 by 2. So magnitude of this will be 2 and this will be 2, so this will be equal to minus 2 upon 4 or minus 1 by 2, or alpha is nothing but minus 1 by 2 cos 1 minus is nothing but 120 degree. So now since alpha is 120 degree, then this is 180 minus 1, that is 60 degree. So theta will be 180 minus 120 divided by 2, that is 30 degree. So your answer is this. I hope you understood this problem. Okay. So let us see this problem. This problem has also come in JEE Advanced 2013. This problem is like this. The image of an object formed by a plano-convex lens at distance of 8 meters behind the lens is real and 1/3 the size of the object. The wavelength of the light inside the lens is 2/3 of the wavelength at free space. So we have to find out the radius of the curved surface, and we have these options. So here what we are given is plano-convex lens, and the distance of the image. So here this is the magnification. Here it is 1/3 the size of the object. So magnification is minus 1/3. And since wavelength is given and it is 2/3 of the wavelength at free space, as you know, refractive index, That is the ratio of the speed of light in the free space to the medium. So from this, the refractive index will be 3 by 2 and image formed is 8 meter behind the lens, so V is 8 meter. So this is our normal formula, lens formula, that is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Putting V, if we rearrange this, we can write this formula as this. V by U is nothing but that is magnification, and it is given as minus 1 by 3. So from this we can find out the focal length, that is coming 6 meter. So for plano-convex lens, this is the formula: focal length is equal to the radius of the curved surface divided by mu minus 1. So this will give you, if you put the value of mu as 3 by 2, it will be 1 by 2. 1 by this 2, it will become 2r, and r will be 3 meters. So this was a very simple problem, but it was as in JEE Advanced 2013. So I hope you understood this problem, and we will come with many more problems like this. And next I am going to upload in few days the video solutions of the mock test 2, that is available on my website, that is GurujiOnline.com. So you can visit there, you can see the mock set, you solve the problems, and you can see the video solutions also. So this is for now. Thank you very much.